There's relief tonight for tens of thousands of Australians plunged into isolation because of a COVID case. National Cabinet has overhauled the definition of close contact. It means many who are in ISO right now will be free by midnight. The changes we're being promised should also reduce those long queues at testing clinics, with at-home swabs to play a much bigger role.
Crunch time, Cabinet and the ACT Chief Minister provided some early commentary.
Now you can tell he's got an election coming up, like he's got cameras in the room, can't you?
Against the backdrop of a federal election campaign, the PM took the driver's seat, unmasked and crunching the gears.
Omicron requires us to undertake a gear change of how we're managing the pandemic. So we need to change who is a close contact.
It's now anyone who's spent 4 hours or more with a confirmed case in a house or household-like setting, such as an aged care facility. They'd only be required to quarantine for 7 days and take a rapid antigen test on day six. If you test positive then, get a PCR test.
If you don't fulfil this definition of a close contact, then there is no need for you to be in that line. You should go home. Go to the beach. Go and do what you want to do. Read a book in the park.
The Prime Minister says he's changing gears, but the truth is he stalled the recovery.
The changes come into effect from midnight tonight in New South Wales, Victoria, Queensland, South Australia and the ACT, from January 1 in Tasmania, and yet to decide the Northern Territory and WA.
These settings appear to have been, as I said, politically expediently introduced, funnily enough, in about 8 hours' time, and just in time for what I would regard as yet another super spreader event, being New Year's Eve.
The changes come as cases begin to soar and hit a heartbreaking new low.
We have some very sad news today. A COVID positive child under the age of two has sadly passed away.
But our health chiefs say new Omicron modelling from South Africa provides real hope.
They are seeing a 73% decrease in severity. That's similar to what we are seeing in Australia. So 1,400 out of 110,000 in hospital. That is much lower than what we've seen before.
Boosters remain key. By early January, 7.6 million Australians will be eligible. There's 3 million doses on shelves now and a further 6 million on their way.
In addition to that, there is another 16 million doses of mRNA sitting in warehouses awaiting delivery. So the supply is not the concern.
And 30 million rapid antigen tests are due by March. With the push to self-administration, more people test themselves, more people treat themselves and never present to a hospital or GP. What does rapidly disappear is the formal statistics. It will be very difficult for any government to monitor the true extent of this pandemic. They can model now.
We're not going to be talking about 8,000 cases in a few weeks. We're going to be talking about tens of thousands of cases. But the good thing is the vaccines are working.
Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.
Now, as Ali mentioned, these changes come as most states smash their 24-hour COVID case records. Today, more than 20,000 infections were detected across Australia. Hospitalisations and deaths are also jumping, especially in New South Wales and, of course, in Victoria, where tragically 13 people died yesterday. And if we take a look at Europe, which is a few weeks ahead of us with its latest outbreak, our infections likely have a long way to go. France and the UK have had their highest ever 24-hour case figure for yet another day. Poland had 794 deaths, but more than three quarters were unvaccinated. And about 60,000 Americans are currently in hospital with the virus. Still, that's only half the number of its last major outbreak a year ago.